supieras, vida mía, lo mucho que te quiero y que te adoro. Tú vives en mi pensamiento y ahora me arrepiento si yo te hice llorar.
Bienvenidos a su radio de la comida, right here off the Miracle Mile in Stockton, California. This is Betty Ramirez with Sabor Latino. Hey, we have music. Feel good about that because finally we have our music right here on your community radio station. TBOSJ.org. This is Betty Ramirez. You know what? I'm going to give you guys a free painting lesson. As soon as I get Facebook up and going, I'm going to go ahead and do that for you for the season. I figure, why not? I have the paints. I have everything I need. So I might as well give you guys a free lesson. Okay? I'm hoping that you'll be able to share it with your family and friends, okay? All right. I'm going to continue with music in the background. On your community radio station, The Voice of San Joaquin, in Stockton, California. This is Betty Ramirez, and I'm going to do a painting lesson, and I'm excited. Okay, getting Facebook on. It looks to me like it's going to come on a little bit, and as soon as it's on, yeah, it's on. So, all right, so here goes. Wish me luck, Noah. I'm going to be on the white mic. And yes, I'm going to continue talking. Yeah, it's picking up, so it looks like it's working. All right, in order to do a painting lesson, I'm going to go over all of the information on materials, on paint brushes, and everything that you're going to need in order to be able to do this. Now, I usually teach three strokes, yeah. I usually do a baby rose, and within an hour, you can actually paint a baby rose. Might not be all that perfect, but as long as you get three strokes, then you can do amazing things. Okay, these are my paints. Okay, this is what I use, and of course this is acrylic paint, water-based paint, which works beautifully, and I have a variety of colors. I like to combine my colors, but since we're doing a fall scene, I had to switch a camera. Since we're doing a fall scene, all the colors that we need, of course, are yellow, right? Yellow. This one here, folk art, is okay to use. I'm going to go ahead and put the music down. This is going to be difficult to juggle, but I'm going to give it a try. Might as well. I've already started it. So, okay. We went over some of the colors. You know what? One of the colors that I really like is this green. And it's almost like a neon green. It's called Lime Tree. And it's an apple barrel. Apple barrel. And again, like I was saying, it is a water-based paint. And this paint is wonderful. It works beautifully. So that's one of the colors, and you know, I am going to pull the yellow. I have two different yellows. One is like a canary. Let's see, this one here is a pale daffodil, it's called. It's also an apple barrel. We're going to go ahead and use that too. Okay, so that's another one. And the dark green, of course, is one that we use all the time, especially this one. This one is like a holiday green apple barrel. Okay, so this one is yellow. I'm going to find another one as well. Oh, orange is another color that we need. Of course, that's something that we can use as well for the fall colors. Orange. We're going to be painting a variety of leaves. And let's see, this is another different orange. This is more like a pastel. And this one is nice. I like it. It's called Tropic Orange. It's also an apple barrel, as you can see. I'm going to see if I could turn over that other camera so we can catch the other paints that I'm showing you here. That's important, so that way you can see what I do in all sorts of directions. Okay, so that's another color that I'm going to use. Of course, black is always good for detailing. Okay. A detailer is definitely really important. Brown as well, for detailing as well, okay? This is another one that works beautifully. And this one here is melted chocolate. So, for a brown. All right, get this one out of the way. That way you guys can see. All right, looks to me like we're okay. So, okay, so there you go. That's another one. Purple is a good color. I'd like to use a little bit of purple, so I'm going to go ahead and pull out the petunia purple. Just in case I want a touch of purple, I'll pull that too. Now, I'm looking at a gray, and this one here is a gray-green. It's called gray-green. It's also folk art, also water-based paint. And so this is another good color. Another pastel color which I like is cameo pink. This is also an apple barrel. So this is another color to pull. Looks to me like I have almost all of them. I'm going to pull some more greens only because during the fall, you know, all the leaves turn different colors of green. And then they keep getting lighter till they're yellow. And then yellow, they go to like a rustic color. And then a reds, burgundies. So here's some reds that I pulled, and these are nice too. This is a flamenco red. So this is an apple barrel as well. And you know, you could get them at Walmart for like 50 cents a piece. Sometimes they have a good sell. When they're a quarter, I go wild, only because you know you want to save on some paints as well. Okay, there's another orange one. This one is called pumpkin orange. This is a good color as well for fall. So I'm gonna pull that one too. This one here is called spice carrot. Spiced carrot. Okay, apple barrel as well. I'm gonna go ahead and pull that one as well. And last but not least, rojo. Rojo bandera, it's called. Okay, it's a flag red. This is a good color. Okay, I have a black for dark if I need it. Did I pull enough green? No, I didn't. Okay, so there's another green here. This one here is called kiwi. Also an apple barrel. Kiwi. And then I'm going to pull... this one's a glow green. I don't want a glow green. But I do need more greens. And this one here is shamrock. Also an apple barrel. Shamrock. Okay. Okay, this is the one. This green here is almost looks like an army green. It's called English ivy green. This is a good green as well. So I have 5 different greens. I do have the bright one, which is my favorite. Lime tree is another one. Okay, I think I have enough greens now to last me all night. Every now and then I like giving lessons because, of course, who doesn't want to learn something new, right? And since it is fall, I figure I might as well pull them out and give you a lesson. All right, so I think I have plenty of colors. You know what? I'm going to pull just a light lavender only because I feel like I need it. So I have a purple and a lavender. So, all right. So these are the colors that I'm going to use. And as you can see, they're all fall colors, which is great. But you could make your own colors too, of course. I'm just gonna turn them over so you can actually see. Okay, I love the fact that we have music now in the background. Whoop, whoop. Love it, love it. And not only that, but know that, of course, our 89.5 FM radio, KBCC in Tracy, is about to happen any time now. So we're gonna be able to go FM. You'll be able to listen to us in your car, at home, on your radio. That is so cool. I'm happy about that. Okay, so what other colors? I think I have enough colors here. I'm just turning them over so you can have an idea of all the colors that I'm using. Okay, so another thing that I use, okay, this is gonna be my blotter, a napkin. A napkin is great to use for taking out the excess water out of your brushes, okay? And I put it on a plate that won't let it leak. It's another one too that I use for mixing. Okay, for the brushes, I'm gonna use a various brushes. And some of them will be cut at a 45 degree angle, as you can see right there. And then some will be just liners. Now the liners are perfect for detailing. Okay, I'm trying to get underneath the camera so you could see my brushes. Okay, so a detailer liner. Here's another one. There's two different types. One is a short and one is the long bristles, and it's horsehair, so it's really fine. Sable, and then some of them is a nylon. Okay, and then I have, of course, other brushes that I like using, a number 10. This is a good brush as well. And these are the flat brushes that I use to create the beautiful leaves that I'm gonna create for you today. And I think we're gonna do a wreath. Why not? A wreath would be good, and we could combine other things in there, like maybe some pine cones or some cherries or some berries. Yeah, berries. All right, so these are my brushes. This is another flat brush. These two are about the same. This one is a 3/4, and this one is number 20, and then I have a half inch. Okay, they're all flat. The only one that I have that is at a 45 degree angle is a smaller brush. I mean, it works just as great. It just has a slant on it. Okay, so these are my brushes. So now I have a total of 6 brushes. 7. All right, so I have a cup of water that I'm gonna use to clean my brushes before I changed over to a different color. I'll always wash my brushes because, of course, acrylic paint dries very fast. And you don't want the paint to dry on the brushes, because if you do, then you're gonna have a problem. You might lose your brush, okay? So yeah, you wanna get the paint out of the bristles as quick as possible. So sometimes I just stick them in water until I'm ready to paint or ready to put them away. Okay, so now that I have the colors here, I'm gonna put them aside so that way I can see what I have here to be able to pull and use. Okay, I am going to paint. I'm gonna show you everything so that way you have an idea more or less what you can find at the art store. And this is a mixed media notepad. Strathmore. It's got 200 sheets. It is a mixed media paper, and it's a good paper. It's got a good surface. Matter of fact, this was a gift from some friends that I thought was so cool when they did that. They didn't have to. They went out of the way. They gave me one of these as a gift. I just feel like, you know, so fortunate to have friends that care enough to sometimes help you out. And you know what? This is This is one of my lessons that I gave before, and it is the three strokes, and this is the baby rose. I just was telling you about in the springtime that I give a lesson to, and people seem to get it real quick and like it. Isn't that beautiful? That's just a purple with like a pale blue, a baby blue, and it worked beautifully. Okay, so I'm gonna find a new page. And then what else can I show you? I think we got everything. This, of course, I'll put my colors on, so that way styrofoam is the best, so that way it doesn't leak through, right? So this will be your palette for your paints. I will put my blotter on another plate, and I'll use that to blot and take the excess of the paintbrush of the water out, because of course you don't want it to be too watery, because then it'll be too runny, right? I'll have a different container to hold the brushes on the side. All right, looks like I'm ready to go. So I'm wetting my brushes so that way they're ready to be used. And you know what? I think I'm gonna wet them all so that way they're done. Okay, remember what I said about the blotter? You blot, just touch. So now my brushes are wet. All right, I'm gonna start with the large brush, and I'm going to use two colors. And my two colors, I'm gonna begin with green. So a light green and a darker green. So I'm gonna try to get in as much colors as I can. I'm gonna combine them side by side. If you haven't shaken them, shake them please. Sometimes it gets a little dry. So I'm gonna put just a little dot. Well, you know what? I might go for a little more because I'm gonna be using this light green a lot. So there's my green. And then I'm gonna put the dark green right next to the green. Right next. I'll put less here. See that? Okay, right next to the green, light green. Okay, and with the brush, I'm going to go center, from the center area. And center area, and I'm gonna push down to press the brush so that way the bristles can open up and spread. And then I'm gonna flop it. As I flop it, I keep flopping back and forth, as I load up the brush. Okay. And once I do that, you wanna make sure that you have, you know, the light green on one side and the dark green on the other side. Okay, this is a must. If you muddy up the paint, then you can wash your brush and start all over. See that? So you gotta have the light green on one side and the dark green on the other side, and you should be ready to go. Start painting. Okay, I am going to do some leaves. And as I stroke the leaves, I'm going to concentrate on what the leaf is gonna look like. So with this particular brush that is wide, you can actually do one leaf just from touching and letting it spread, and you pull. You see that? Touch, spread, pull. Touch, and as it spreads, you pull it to get that little point. Okay, this is gonna be a wreath, so I'm gonna just take it around as much as I can, even if it's a small stroke. Remember, now the leaves do not have to be identical. I want them to be different. Remember, fall time, you find all sorts of different leaves, right? So it's gonna be a wreath, so I'm gonna go in a circle, touch, and I'm gonna pull, touch, pressure, pull, touch, pressure, and pull, touch, pressure, and pull, touch, pressure, and pull. So when I say pressure, I'm putting pressure onto the brush so the bristles can open up, and then I pull it for the point, okay? Not difficult to do. You could do a different type of leaf every now and then, so that way it has a feeling of you know, two different type of trees next door. One could be an oak, one could be a pine. Sometimes if you zigzag back and forth, you can get that zigzag inside the center of where the two colors meet, okay? And so far I have two, okay, there you go, two colors. And I'm going to put the brush away. And I'm gonna pull another brush.
There's always two sides to a story.
Okay.
I consider myself one of those artists that think outside the box, you know what I'm saying? Check it. Joe, let's not get ahead of
ourselves. Okay, now I'm gonna pull another color. Since I've already started with the green, I'm going to pull the yellow. And the yellow, I think I'm gonna use a yellow and an orange. So we'll pull the both two colors. Yellow and orange, again, my acrylic paint. And what I'm gonna do the same thing. Make sure that it is mixed. And I'll put paint down again. I could still pull from this light green just by touching it with my brush, so I don't have to put it right next door. Okay, yellow and orange. Two good colors. This yellow is a little on the thick side. That's okay. Alright, so again, I have the two colors, and this time I'm going to use a different brush. Now, all my brushes are wet already. And again, from the center, I'm going to push, and as I'm putting pressure, the bristles are spreading open, and I'm picking up orange and yellow. Orange and yellow. Keep going back and forth, back and forth. Make sure that my brush is completely loaded. All right. So now I'm ready to add some more leaves. So touch and squiggle it. Touch, squiggle it. Squiggle there. Touch, squiggle, and twist and pull. Same thing over here. Now, since this wreath is going to be so full of different color leaves, it's going to look beautiful. You can add some more leaves in a different shape. They, like I said, they don't have to be identical. Some could be thin and elongate the strokes so you can get a different type of leaf. Touch and elongate, just pull. You can make them thin, you can make them really wide. Okay, so there's the orange. Now I'm gonna go ahead and pull the red and add some red color leaves as well. Remember that this is gonna fill up with a lot of leaves. And so I'm gonna put the red next to the orange, since that's a perfect color for another fall leaf. And I'm gonna pull another brush. It's wet already. This is my blotter. Touch. I want to wet it again, blot, get rid of the excess of the water. Okay, again, now I'm going to pull, this time orange and red together, and I'm going to flop it, and pull, flop, pull. So back and forth, and these are two brilliant, beautiful colors. Okay, so now I'm going to add some more leaves, and this time I'm going to do slightly different leaf, and it has squiggles. When I squiggle, I move the brush around, and as you move the brush around, it gives you the two-tone effect, but it also gives you a beautiful blend effect. When you run out of paint, you go back and do the same thing. Remember, if you do muddy your paint brush, that means if you combine both colors and you get all the colors mixed up on each end, then you could start all over. Okay, here's another one. Touch, and I'm gonna squiggle and pull. Touch, and I'm gonna squiggle it and pull. Touch, squiggle, and pull. Okay, touch, and I'm gonna move it around and pull. This is brilliant, as it's such a beautiful, bright color. You could, you know, make some really thin ones, some wide ones again. Going in to grab some more paint. I could also touch a little bit of yellow on that end of the yellow. And here's another leaf. That's just so beautiful. You can also overlap. When you overlap, it's just beautiful. Okay. It will not wreck your leaves if you overlap, so don't be afraid to do that. Again, picking up some more paint. Again, acrylic paint is I love it because it lasts a long time before it really sets. It gives you enough time to lay something down that you are working on getting at least the effect of it. And pull, touch, and pull, touch, and pull. Now you can go over your stroke if you'd like, over again. Just because you stroked it once doesn't mean you can't overlap, okay? You can go back in and stroke. Sometimes people tell me, oh, I made a mistake. I said, no, your mistake is incorporated into your art. It's not a mistake, unless you tell everybody it is. Just have fun with it. And here's another different leaf. Just pull it, elongate it. Another leaf here, pulling and elongating it. Overlapping the green. Don't be afraid to overlap, touch and pull. Okay, now I'm going to, since I have the red, orange, and yellow, I'm going to do something here that I'm going to challenge and add some, I think some brown. Now you could put the brown next to the yellow. See what effect you get. Now I'm going to use the same brush that I've been using for the red and orange and yellow. And I'm going to pull those two colors. Now that I have all these colors mixed in, I'm just gonna go crazy with this one here. Okay, beautiful. You want to get some of that brown in there because that brown, of course, it just gives it such a beautiful fall color. It really makes it, it gives you a feel of fall. Again, I go back in and I pick up same flopping. Now you can combine, or you could hit the corner of the brush into the red, so that way you have red added in there. And here I go, adding another different type of a leaf. Here's another one. Touch, pull, and twist. As I twist, I get that point. And once I get that point, then of course you succeed in making a beautiful little leaf. I'm gonna go back in and I'm gonna make sure that I get the brown and the brown, the yellow and the yellow. And now I'm gonna stick it into some orange. Okay, here goes. And get ready to just add more. Combining and overlapping. I like that. That works. Overlapping. Touch. Pull. It's looking so pretty. I love the colors. Again, fall time is such a beautiful time to get out there with your families and, you know, go up to the higher elevation areas and just enjoy the beautiful fall colors, the trees. So I'm gonna go in and get some orange and yellow and combine and more. Okay, these leaves are looking pretty good. Okay, touch, pull, and twist. And here you go. I'm getting some really nice leaves out of this brown, red, and yellow. Okay, I didn't use too many of the dark green or the light green, only because it's more fallish. I just wanted to have a hint of the green in there. Okay, now that I did that, I'm going to add just, again, I'm going to get a little more brave here and add a little purple in there. Why not? And the purple I'm going to combine next to the brown, just a little. And I'm going to pick up again, yellow and brown, and then touch a little of the red and orange, and here, touch a little bit of the purple. See what kind of effect I get now. Oh, beautiful. Very different, but beautiful to the eye. It just gives a hint of color. You don't want it to be too purple, but it sure looks pretty. Overlapping. Okay, coming back to pick up more of my paint, yellow and brown, and dip it into the red, orange, and now I'm gonna pick up some purple into the red area. Okay, and touch, pull, go. Gives it a nice effect. And pull, picking up some purple. Touch and pull. So simple. These strokes is just simple. It's just, I call it the comma stroke, because when you touch your paper and press your brush, the bristles spread out. And like I said, you can get a wide stroke, you can get a thinner stroke, you could even get a thin liner stroke, you know. It's just the amount of pressure that you put on the brush, okay? So here I go, I'm gonna pick up some more of the yellow. Now, I see that my brush is getting muddied up pretty good, but I'm still going because it's still working for me. Because I want all the colors, I don't mind that. Okay, now I'm gonna get into smaller strokes in areas that are tight. And now I can get creative and really paint, pick up more of the other paint that I have combined here. I'll pick up more yellow and just keep adding until you have your wreath nice and full. Yeah, don't be afraid to get creative with the green as well. You want some green in there as well, so that way you can combine all your colors and bring them all together. And so far it's working. I love it. It looks really good. I'm happy with it. Now when you combine all your colors, let it happen, only because fall colors, that's what it is. All colors coming together. And it just looks so beautiful. You could add more of the green if you'd like, the light green. I that's what I'm doing. And it's giving me a really beautiful fall color. And don't forget, like I said, it's okay to overlap. You want to do that. Again, you want to fill this whole sheet of nothing but beautiful leaves. And then you'll have a beautiful fall color wreath that you can frame and put up and say, hey, I did this. I painted my own fall leaf wreath. Okay, so because that green is pops, I really like it. I'm going to use it with my liner. And once I do that, you're going to see it's going to really bring it in together. Just making sure that I get some other spots I may have missed. Now, I love the way it's just bringing everything together. Okay, so look. looks to me like that's pretty good. I'm going to go ahead and use, well, you know what? I have the two liners. Remember I was telling you about the two liners? One is longer and one is shorter. The shorter is going to give you a thicker line, and then the thinner one is going to give you a long, thin line. But this one is a little difficult to control, especially when you control when you scroll, because it is long. It's got long bristles, and it's about an inch. The other one's half an inch. And what I thought I would do is combine it with the light green. I'm going to add water to an edge, just a little bit, just so that way I can make it more fluid. If I make it more fluid, then I can scroll and make thinner lines. Okay, here goes. So the thin lines are going to go around and around and around, and I'm going to bring it in this way. This is a beautiful color, and this is going to make it complete. You know what? You could combine it. If you have a leaf that still has fresh paint, scroll through it. That way you can pick up another color that looks so beautiful. Again, scrolling, scroll, scroll. And it is picking up reds. It's picking up some green. I'm not afraid to scroll it in and over the leaves. Just gives it such a beautiful look. So we'll scroll here and scroll over here. Okay, so I used the green. I let it combine with some of the reds. And now I'm going to wash my brush. And now I'm going to pull some red. Again, when you add water to your red, keeps it from drying. But it also keeps it fluid. You don't want a really thick line, right? You want to get it as thin as you can so you can scroll. Okay, now I'm going to scroll here and I'm going to pull it in the center. It's a little red scroll. Come around on the outside and scroll again. Pick up some more of the red. This red is brilliant. You can scroll large, you can scroll small. Just, it's your painting. You do what you want with your painting. If you want to scroll a lot, you scroll less. It's up to you. Okay, so I went ahead and added some red. I'm going to wash my... Oops. I washed it in the wrong container. Okay, I'm going to pull some orange now. Only because I want some orange lines. Pull it in. I'm going to add a little water in there so that way it's diluted. And that way, again, I could get a thin layer of orange paint. Okay, now I'm going to scroll it and bring it in so you can see it from the center. Scrolling, scrolling. Scrolling again and bringing it in the center. Okay, another color too that you can scroll with is the yellow. Once I'm done with the orange. The orange is beautiful. Am I covering it? Sorry, I was actually covering it. Only because I wanted to make sure that I got that red. I'm going to go ahead and pull the yellow and put the yellow on the side. And I'm going to add water in there and dilute and get a thin layer. Okay. And so the yellow's ready, so I'm going to scroll again with the yellow. It's looking very beautiful. And bring the yellow on the outer so you can see the color pop. Okay, need some scrolling here. Anyhow, all these colors just brings it all together. Don't be afraid to stroke a little bit, you know, a little stroke here and there. Sometimes I do like to do little spirals, but at the same time, a half a spiral is good enough. Just to give it the hint of that color. That's beautiful. That came out really nice. I'm happy with it. Okay, so there it is. Isn't that beautiful? And like I said, it's a wreath with all fall colors. And there's an area that I feel like it needs something else, so I'm gonna add some scrolling. So far, I like what I see. Okay, and once I'm done, of course, you initial it, you put your name on there. And so I usually do initials, VR. And I'll try to do my initial and my last name. And then I usually do the year. And so there it is. There's that beautiful piece. I hope you like it, and I hope you like the lesson. Now, I can actually do another lesson. Why don't I do that? I'm gonna show you some of the flowers that we could do for fall. And some of the flowers could be mums, right? Marigolds is another one. So I'm gonna open this up and lay it out just like that. I'm not gonna fold it yet because I'm gonna let it dry. That way dries nice. Okay, remember what I said about combining the two colors. When you run out, you always add some more and try to keep it from getting muddy. Very important. Try to keep your colors separate. Now the orange is really nice. I really like this color. Okay, that one was kind of thick, but this one here is like a pastel. Don't forget to shake your colors, a little pastel. I still have yellow, so I'm good there. Okay, one of my brushes that I didn't completely wash because I knew I was going to use it, the yellow and the orange. So I'm going to go ahead and pull it and start picking up the color. Okay, so some of the leaves I'm going to do right here. Oh, you know what? I said I was going to do a flower, so we could do, you know what? I'll do an iris just to do it for the heck of it. Okay, I will start with the highlight on the outer and outside, and the dark color inside towards me. Okay, and here's one of the strokes I will start with it, and I will wave it. And there's one of the leaves right there. Look how beautiful. The two colors combined has a beautiful shadow to it. Going back and picking up some more and getting the orange and red. Okay, and then I'm going to bring it on the outer and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to touch and wave the brush, wave as I'm going like in a circle, and I bring it in. The iris flower is just so beautiful, and you know what? I'm glad I'm doing it for you because it's just gorgeous. It shows you what you can do with just one brush. Look at that, you have the shadow and the highlight at the same time. Gorgeous. Beautiful, 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 beautiful. I hope that you so far have been enjoying my painting. This is Betty Ramirez, my number 470-9585. If ever you want to get on the list for lessons, would love to give you a lesson. That'd be superb. Okay, so here's the next stroke. outer bushing and I'm waving it. Wave. And now I'm bringing it inside. That was beautiful too. Okay, now I'm gonna pick up my yellow and my orange and put in with the burgundy and center. This is gonna be the center stroke, center petal, touch, and I'm just letting it wave work. Oops, need some of the red burgundy. And there's my other stroke. I'm gonna do it again. I muddied it up just a little bit, but I'm gonna pick it up. And now the next stroke is gonna be center. And pull, and bring it in. Just a little while longer, wanna pray, can get you off of my soul. And that was my other stroke on the outer petal. Just for loving me. Complete. And there you go. All right, since I do have the green, I'm going to go ahead and use a different brush, touch blot, and I'm going to pick up the green with two colors right in the center. All right, so there's the green. It's starting to dry up a bit. And with this, we can actually do some really pretty long stem and stem leaves. So I'm going to touch from the center base of the iris, touch and pull. As I'm pulling, I'm bringing it down. I'm also turning slightly. Okay. Looks like it's a good blend. Okay, the irises have really long leaves and they're thin and wide. So let me see if I can actually do the... Oh, I might not be able to. Well, I'll give it a try because this is a small brush. This is a perfect brush for stemming. Stem. Alright, so here goes. And we'll do here, or start it from here, and I'm going to let it get wide and put pressure on it. Look at that. Going back, and I'm gonna complete it. That was difficult to do because this brush is not as wide, but that's okay. I still accomplished what I wanted to do. Touch pressure and go as wide as this brush would permit me to give me a wide stroke for the leaf. Okay. And again, I'm going to pick up more paint. And we're going to do the same thing on the other side. And this one will be a smaller leaf. Touch and I'm pressing so I get a wide stroke. Okay. And then from here, I'm gonna give it another touch, pull, and pull. If you did not fill in, it's okay to go over it to make sure that you did fill. Okay, right here you got the highlight of the light green, and over here you have the highlight of the shadow. Not a highlight, just shadow. So it works. I like it. Okay, and then from here I can actually pull some small little strokes. Makes it look like grass. Using the same brush. And since the brush is almost dry, it gives it a nice grassy effect. Okay, and that's my iris, the beautiful iris. And there you go. Isn't that beautiful? And again, I could give lessons in the springtime. That's when I start. And a lot of people like taking a lesson then. So call me and get on that list so that way I can give you a call and let you know when the next class is going to be. My number is 209-467-4455. Let's make it happen, okay? Let's make it happen for you. I would like to show you one more only because the next one is... It's almost dry. Good. The next one is a pumpkin. And the pumpkin, well, because of fall, that's what you see a lot, right? So I think I'm going to do one for you. Okay. This one here. I think this is probably a different shape. All right, this one here is going to require all the colors that I've been using, which is the orange, the yellow. I'll use some of the pastel as well. And I'll add pastel in there, make sure it's mixed. And there's a pastel, sounds like a canary yellow. Okay, and I'm gonna add more of the orange because it seems like I'm almost out of the orange. That was the first one here. It's a pretty bright orange, and this one is called the pumpkin orange. Perfect. I'll put it next to the yellow. Oh, what time is it? Okay, I still have time because I know that Greg does a show today, and he'll be coming in about Ralph Furley Caravan. His show's called. I still have another, 20 minutes before I have to stop. So here you go. So we have the yellow, the orange, and we still have some brown. Looks to me like the red is almost completely used up, so I'm going to add a little bit more. But I'm going to add the other red as well. And the other red is the red of the flag. And what perfect color, you know, being that we've been celebrating the veterans. Just thanking them, you know, when you see a veteran, let them know how much we appreciate them in so many different ways, you know. Buy them a coffee, give them a handshake, you know. Maybe even buy them a meal. Whatever you want, just let them know how much we appreciate them. And then the red is going to go next to the burgundy as well. Yeah, this is a brilliant red. This will work as well. Okay, still have green, so I don't have to put down any more green because I like using up all my paint. Okay. So I want to make sure that the brushes are wet. So when I need them, I don't have to wet them anymore because they're already wet. Okay, now this brush here hasn't been used, so I'm going to go ahead and use it. First, I'm going to check the other one. Looks like it's okay. All right, so I'm going to pick up the two colors, and the two colors, I'm going to start with the yellow and orange. And let the brush just pick it up, soak it up. And the orange, you know, I'm gonna touch it into the red just slightly because I want that effect. Okay, so here goes. I'm gonna start with the first stroke, which will be up and over. And as I bring it down and around, almost like a backward C. Okay, I like it. I'm gonna pick up the same colors and pick up more of the orange and maybe just a little bit of the brown. And I'm going to do the same thing, and I'm going to bring another stroke in the center and bring it. It's like a moon. Again, I'm pick up the same colors, and as I do that, I'm trying the two different other colors that I have on the side. And this will be another stroke and let it open up the bristles, and here you go. It's looking like a mighty beautiful pumpkin. And again, let's see, picking up the two colors. And now I'm going to still pick up some burgundy and maybe a little bit of the brown. Another stroke, another slice. There you go. Again, picking up my colors. And again, you are listening to TVOSJ.org, the voice of San Joaquin Community Radio, right here off the Miracle Mile in Stockton, California. This is Betty Ramirez with Sabor Latino. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you're enjoying this segment. Okay, here's another stroke coming around. All right. And then I'm going to do probably a couple more. I could bring them in too in the center. Again, making sure that my colors, yellow is in the yellow, orange is in the orange. And then it goes, brings in the others in the center. Touch, touch, pull, touch, pull. Okay, so far it looks good. All right, and now I could touch a little bit of the green. Still pick up some orange and some burgundy and pick up these two colors. And in the center, I'm going to do the cork. Touch, pull, and do a little twist. And see that it combined with the green. Now, I like adding the greens in here. Now I'm going to add some leaves. And that way it gives a good feel that there's some leaves hugging it all around. And this is where you can get creative with the color of your leaves. Touch, pull, touch, let it spread and pull. Okay, picking up some more green. And I'm just having fun with this right now. And it looks to me like it's coming out to be okay. Touch, pull, green, green leaves. Pull, touch, pull. And then every now and then, I'm going to go ahead and pick up some burgundy and red. Touch, pull, twist, touch, pull, twist. Same thing. All right. Looks to me like it's pretty fallish in color. All right. So I'm done with that. Now I'm going to use the smaller liner. It's half an inch. And now this is where I get creative. And if I want to use just a dark green, I could use just a dark green. If I want to use just a light green, but you know what? I'm going to do both. I'm going to add a little bit of some water into the dark green. And I'm going to give it just a little quirky look. There you go. And now I'm going to combine it with the light green. And just go to town and do some scrolling. Again, I can pull out any of the colors that is still wet. I like doing that. And there's my pumpkin. Now the pumpkin has all the colors that you need in there. You can actually add a leaf if you choose to, but I choose not to add a leaf. I choose just to leave it alone. And I did a little bit of the scrolling, one, two, three, four places. And I figure I could call it good, just like that. Yeah, I'm happy with that. I like it. All right, so wash my brush. And there it is. So I did a pumpkin, I did an iris. And then I also did the wreath, right? And I hope that you enjoy them. I hope that you really like my lesson. And like I said, if you would like to have lessons, painting lessons in the springtime, all you have to do is give me a call and I'll get you on the list. So that way, once springtime comes around, I can give you a call and we can come in and learn to paint. This is called a Norwegian style of painting with Betty Ramirez style. And when I say Betty Ramirez style, yeah, I really put in my own style in there. So there's a Latin touch in there as well. And sometimes I'll even go in there with a felt pen and design around the leaves or through the leaf stems or add some other different design, maybe even a border. That would make it look really, really nice. But it looks to me like my pumpkin is pretty wet. It's going to take a while before it dries. But as long as you get an idea of the artwork that you would be taught by me. I hope that you like it. And think about taking my class in the springtime. And, of course, never forget to sign your work so that way people know who did it, who actually painted it, and go from there. All right. This has been Betty Ramirez right here on Sabor Latino on your community radio station. Happy to do this lesson for you. Sorry, the camera's a little cockeyed, a little crooked. But I was happy to do this. Oops. Let's see. No, this is the one that's wet. So I think we're good. Yeah. All right. Yeah, the others are good. Oh, here I was thinking that I may have messed it up, but no, it's good. It's good. It's all good. All right. So I hope you enjoyed the lesson because I know I enjoyed giving it to you. And I shall see you next time right here on your community radio station. Remember that we are, hey there, I guess one of our other DJs just came in and probably is going to get ready to do their show. So I have like 15 minutes to go before Greg comes in. So first I want to let you know about a Dressing Cinderella event. And Dressing Cinderella's, this is the second holiday craft and vendor fair, December the 8th, 2019. This is taking place at Sherwood Mall from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. Vendors are welcome, so if you would like to have a table there and sell some of your goods, then get a hold of Ingrid. Ingrid at 209-420-7838, or you could also call Nicole at 209-298-2670. Okay, all right, there's the information. Hi, Richard. So that little flyer that's right there, Richard, can you give it to me? The white one, the small one that is hanging up on the left. That one right there, the small one, the small white one. It's called Peaceful Holiday. I have a feeling that's going to be taking place the 6th of December, right? And so I want to make sure that I put it out there. And that is for peace and justice as well. And of course, this is an event that I don't think you should miss because it's Peaceful Holiday Fair, December the 6th, 2019, Friday from 4 to 8:30 p.m. So, hey, you can go on out there with your family and shop. You know, there's going to be a lot of Christmas stuff, right? A lot of, and Saturday, December the 7th, 2019. And that is from 10 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. And that's 3700 Pacific Avenue, Stockton, California, at the Central United Methodist Church across from the University of the Pacific. It is a holiday tradition, a local artist creating goods that support a sustainable environment and reflect a caring and a just society. So don't miss it. That's a good one. That's a good one. So, yeah, I'm going to see if I could be out there to cover it. And who knows, maybe I'll bring some of my paintings out there to sell. I may do that. I urge you to. So, you know, if there was a number here, you could give us a call here and leave your name and number if you're interested in a booth. It's 209-467-4455. Leave your name and number, and we'll get back to you in regards to that. All right. This is Betty Ramirez. Thank you so much for tuning in. And I hope you enjoyed my painting lessons. I really, really enjoyed what I painted, and I hope you did too. All right. This is Betty Ramirez signing off. Thank you so much.